sorry, Thursday. I almost forgot it was Thursday at this point. The Honorable Opposition House Leader with the Thursday question.
Just quickly, Mr. Speaker, we also have Bill C-30 outstanding. That's the so-called Lawful Access Bill. And it was up for debate at some point. It just seems to have disappeared off the radar. That along with C-4, both of them really quite misguided legislation. I'm wondering if the House Leader can tell us whether in fact they're going to go ahead with these bills or come to their senses, send them back for either rewriting or just drop them completely.
In terms of Bill C-30, I think he's well familiar that it is our intention to have that debated and sent to committee before second reading, and in so doing being able to allow a broad ambit for the committee to consider amendments of all types. And I think that responds to the particular concerns that he raises on that. In the case of C-30, C-4, and the immigration bill, of course, you can see from the program I've read there will not be an opportunity, barring some dramatic progress on other legislation on the final day, to deal with those bills before the Easter break, so we will have to wait until after that. Thank you.
The discussion was catapulted into the spotlight with a now famous statement from our next guest. Joining me now from Ottawa is Public Safety Minister Vic Toews. Thank you, sir, for being with us. Few things you have done in your long public life have got the volume of criticism that Bill C-30 has. That statement, either with us or with child pornographers.
He can either stand with us or with the child pornographers.
Police agree with you. The public does not. Your words were interpreted as a national insult. Have you regrets?
Well, let's make this clear here. When the Liberals brought in the bill, and this the comment was directed at the Liberals because they're the ones who flipped on the position. When they brought in the bill, they said this bill was intended to protect Canadian children against child pornographers. Then we have the mystery of them standing up and saying, we're not supporting the bill. My comment to the Liberals in the context of a House vote makes perfect sense.
How can we trust Conservatives with such sweeping powers when they used Facebook to keep law-abiding Canadians out of a public meeting? Is this 2012 or 1984, Mr. Speaker? How can we trust them not to use private information to intimidate law-abiding Canadians gathering, say, to protest a pipeline or protest pension cuts?
Okay, is anything going to change? The hot-button issue in this bill is giving police warrantless access to our internet addresses, to who owns that computer. Is that going to change?
Well, in fact, the bill doesn't give warrantless access. There is nothing in Bill C-30 that changes the substantive law in respect of access to private communications, whether it's emails or whether it's following somebody doing web searches. The legislation simply updates the language of the law to accommodate the new reality of the internet. The debate that we're having today on C-30 happened in all of the countries that have passed this same legislation. All other Western democracies have this legislation. Canada stands by itself in that respect. And so the issue is one of simply bringing Canada up to these standards. But the same debate occurred 40 years ago when we talked about wiretap, exactly the same debate.
So you're not changing anything significant in this bill. It's going to carry on.
Well, what we have indicated to the public is that we are going to bring the bill back to the House, to a committee, prior to second reading. Usually it happens after second reading. What this means is that there can be a full examination of the bill, and indeed amendments can be made that are beyond the scope of the bill, which cannot be done after second reading. So we're giving a lot of discretion to the possibility of amendments. But to date, I've not yet been able to understand exactly what the concern is, given that the bill, in its present form, does not allow for warrantless access to private communications. Indeed, what the bill does is simply reintroduce the old Liberal bill, which the Liberals brought in, as I mentioned earlier, back in 2005, and then add certain privacy safeguards for individuals. We have improved not only the privacy safeguards, but accountability. And remember, Lorna, this is a bill that every single attorney general and public safety minister in this country asked our federal government to do. 2 weeks before I introduced the bill into the House, they specifically, at a national conference, said, please proceed with this bill, and that's what I did.